Ah, yes. Tea. Don't you just love.
Okay, let's skip the intro. You saw it on the coffee video.
But before we get into painting with a tea, we need to do a few swatches because I don't know how these teas work and I need to get familiar with them. I've been drinking this tea called Lemon Zinger lately, which has this beautiful red color. But as you can see, as it dries over time, it turns into this grayish purple color. If you don't remember what it looks like, here's another swatch of that beautiful pink red that it used to have. I really like this gray purple tone that it turns into, but originally I was hoping to do a red and green illustration for December, but that's okay. I still really enjoyed painting with the Lemon Zinger because the color is really nice and it was a lot easier to work with than the green tea, which you will see later on. So just like in my coffee art challenge, I thought I would create another character drinking tea and them being, I don't know, in a complete experience as I described it, I think, in the coffee video. I wanted to create a similar illustration to the coffee, so I drew a man, or a boy, a nice chunky boy, he's so cute, drinking this tea. He's so relaxed because coffee and tea are very different. I think coffee is meant to wake you up, whereas tea, I think, has a lot of relaxing options, such as sleepy time, and a lot of tea comes decaffeinated. Plus, whenever I drink tea, it's usually in the middle of the day or at the end of the day when I'm just trying to relax and wind down. I'll be honest though, I'm actually not a fan of green tea, or I guess matcha I should be calling it. Something about the taste is just a little bit off to me. It smells pretty good, but when I drink it, it almost has a seaweedy taste and I don't know why. There's a lot of things messed up with my taste buds. I can't drink eggnog, for example, because it tastes like bubblegum to me. You can Google that, it's a thing. I'm not alone in this bubblegum eggnog world. Enough about eggnog, let's talk about this tea illustration. As you can see, this is where I started to use the thicker green tea that I had mixed up. When I brewed the green tea, I used different amounts of the powder. I keep calling it green tea, but I guess I mean matcha. I used different amounts of the matcha powder and mixed in water just to see what kinds of colors I could get and intensities of that green. But unfortunately, the more powder I used, the thicker and more, I guess, chalky or just mushy it became. It's very similar to using really cheap watercolor cakes. Similar to Artist Loft, actually. You just get this really chalky, hard to work with and hard to get a smooth texture medium, and it's just very hard to work with, and it kind of made me sad, but I kept going with it. This is the point where I started to regret using green tea at all. I really enjoyed the color of the Lemon Zinger and the way that it was going on very smoothly, and I wish I had just done the one color, but I do enjoy having a two-toned illustration this time compared to the coffee where there was just the one tone. I had also mixed a very thick matcha to hopefully do the line art with, but it was ending up sort of like the way I did the coffee, where it was just very chunky and it just wasn't good to work with, and I didn't want to ruin it any more than it already was with the streaky green tea. So later on, you will see that I did give in and actually use a micron pen to line the illustration instead of using tea. So I do feel a little bad about not just sticking purely with tea for this illustration, but I still like the way it turned out. So I'm gonna give myself a pass on that one. I was quite surprised with how easily the Lemon Zinger was able to layer on. It only took one layer and I had quite a contrast between the base color and just the additional shadows. And of course, the more I worked with the Lemon Zinger and how great it worked, I got more and more sad about that green tea. Because this is a tea version of the coffee illustration that I did before, I wanted to also do that ring of explosion of tea energy, I suppose, coming off of this person. Though I really struggled with this one. I don't know if it's because tea has a thicker consistency than coffee, because coffee is basically water and barely any coffee in it, but it just seemed like I couldn't get any of this tea to be pushed by the air. The green tea I understood because it was a mixture of a powder and water, so it did get a little thicker. But with the Lemon Zinger, I was really surprised at how much trouble I was having with getting it to just be pushed by the air. It just wouldn't do it, and I don't know why. Does tea get denser as you brew it? I don't know, but I couldn't get those beautiful sprays like I did on my coffee one, so I was a little sad about that. But something that I did want to play around with was having the two colors of tea. So I did have the red and the green kind of mixed together as they went off of this person. And I do think the colors went really well together, and I'm really happy with how they turned out. You know, those nice earthy tones that I like so much. They aren't vibrant and in your face, but they've got this earthy tone. Actually, matcha has quite a sap green color, which is my favorite watercolor ever. So I was quite happy about that. And I do not like purple. As you guys know, I hate the color purple, but this grayish purple red tone, I love it. I love this lemon zinger tea so much that I'm very tempted to do a monotoned tea challenge in the future. Maybe later on when I'm out of ideas, huh? After I was done pushing the tea around with my hairdryer, I tried to do some splatters here and there, and again, it just wasn't flying off the brush with the same, I don't know, explosion like the coffee was. When I threw the coffee down on the other one, it went out in these really nice looking splashes, but the tea just kind of splatted down in these little circles, so I don't know. Tea, you really let me down on this one. And after I was done with my finishing touches of my splatters, it was time to ink. I had debated for a while if I wanted to attempt to do the green tea or matcha line art with the thicker one, but in the end, I decided that the matcha just wasn't dark enough to do a line, and I didn't want to see this suffer any more than it did. Those streaky matcha strokes were already making me so sad, so I thought the only thing that could actually save this illustration would be a proper line. So of course I broke out my pens, and instead of using a full stroke, I went with my little dotted broken line, and I really like the way it looks with how rough the, I guess, the T is, and it's not this smooth, solid structure. So I think the broken lines really add to it. I'm becoming more and more fond of these broken lines because there's just something about them, the way they add texture and just more interest to illustrations. I really, really like the way they look. So despite my struggles with the matcha, I wanted to thank you guys for giving me the push to do the painting with tea. I pondered if it was even a thing in my coffee video, and the comments demanded that I try to paint with tea. So here we are. I'm happy with the results and I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you so much to all of my patrons, including Michael Young, Sarah James, Josh Perry Buck, Alice Tries, Rochelle Renee, Hannah, Bellasaurus, Jonathan Chihuahua, and Oni. If you want a shout out at the end of my videos, access to my sketchbook, coloring pages, and more, become my patron by clicking the link in the description. Thank you all so much for the support. Bye!